seeking knowledge, and he put it ahead of any other function in life, including marriage, for the students to go and finish their education. And he had many, many beautiful statements. As a matter of fact, one of his best books, I don't know if we received it or not, The Book of the Teacher and the Student, Fiqh al-Alim wal-Mutaallim. And by the way, any one of you can tell me, where is this name Abu Hanifa came from?
That was my question.
He doesn't have a boy with the name Hanifa. His firstborn boy is Hamad. He named him after his teacher, Hamad ibn Abi Sulaiman. He doesn't have a girl, a daughter, whose name Hanifa.
Huh?
It is a name which paint to us his character, what he was doing in his youth.
What was it?
Abu Hanifa, like Abu Huraira. We know Abu Huraira name or nickname came from taking care of a little kitten. Carry it every place he goes or doesn't bother it. One time the kitten was sleeping on his garment. Not to wake it up, he cut the garment around the cat. I mean, those stories, we need our children to know about them. Abu Hanifa, in his youth, he was so eager to learn. And he would go from one teacher to one teacher, carrying with him the instruments of writing. And what is the instrument of writing at that time? Was the ink bottle and the feather. This ink of bottle and feather, in the colloquial language of Iraq, called Hanifa. So he's Abu Hanifa, he's like Mr. Ink Bottle. We see this with Ibn Qayyim. Ibn Qayyim, it's not his name. Ibn Qayyim al-Jawziyah. His father was a principal of a school called a Jawziyah. Qayyim al-Jawziyah means the principal of the school. So he's the son of the principal of the school. Now we, you know, say, what is Ibn Qayyim al-Jawziyah? So Ibn Abu Hanifa, his name came, that's nickname like nowadays we use Mr. Wrench or Mr. Stethoscope or Mr. something, you know, which tells about his interest. Abu Hanifa's interest was in learning. And as a young kid, he would carry with him the bag with it, the instrument of writing and the ink. They did not have that reservoir in the pens. You have to, you know, every time you write a sentence to lick it inside the ink bottle. So this is where the name of Abu Hanifa came. Abu Hanifa was very keen on the methodology of learning. It was very similar to what we have nowadays in the West, not in the rest of the world, which is open discussion where the teacher more or less like the student. He doesn't have the grandeur position like Malik. Malik was sitting on a throne. Of course, it's not something for him, but he was glorifying the hadith of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Abu Hanifa was in the setting of nowadays like our own colleges and universities. He will be probably leading the discussion or the debate, but he was one of the present people, and all of them, they talk together. And I will mention a story, Waqi' ibn al-Jarrah. We know he's one of the fuqaha. He was a teacher of Imam Shafi'i, one of his teachers. And we know that from the beautiful poetry. Imam Shafi'i one time had problem remembering, so he asked his teacher, he told him, look into yourself. If you have done anything wrong, you know. So he said, شَكَوْتُ إِلَى وَكِيعٍ سُوءَ حِفْظِي فَأَرْشَدَنِي إِلَى تَرْكِ الْمَعَاصِي وَأَخْبَرَنِي أَنَّ الْعِلْمَ نُورٌ وَنُورُ اللَّهِ لَا يُهْدَى لِعَاصِي. Here's our teacher, Dr. Please come forward, brother. Waqi' ibn Jarrah was asked, did Abu Hanifa make a mistake? And his answer was, how come he would make a mistake? And the setting he sits in, on his right is Abu Yusuf and Zufar and Muhammad ibn Al-Hasan, and they are what they are in their qiyas and ijtihad. And next, Yahya ibn Zakariya and Hafs ibn Ghiyath and Habban and Mundil, and they are authority in the hadith. And next to them, Al-Qasim ibn Ma'an, and he was authority in the language and grammar and Arabic understanding. And Dawood al-Ta'i and Al-Fudayl ibn Iyad, and both of them are the most in their austerity and their righteousness. This is the setting of Abu Hanifa when he makes his decision. After debating with all these great figures, he would tell Abu Yusuf, write it down. So he wasn't a dictator. He wasn't a teacher who dictates on others, and what I say is right, and everything else is not. Quite the opposite. I mean, Abu Hanifa and the rest of the imams of the school of thoughts, all of them, they have made statements glorifying the Quran, the hadith of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the Sahaba al-Kiram, and then they come to their ijtihad, and they tell you that my ijtihad is the best what I can do. It might be wrong, it carry with it certain percentage might be wrong, I might reverse it tomorrow. So there wasn't that spasm in opinions, that jealousy, which now we see it later on after 500 years when the school of thoughts became like parties, like political parties. For any little thing you find wars happen. This jealousy was not there. And we have to understand that the students of Abu Hanifa were his students in the methodology, not necessarily with his opinion. Abu Yusuf and Muhammad ibn al-Hasan al-Shaybani, they're the most, and Zufar, the most brilliant students. They disagree with him, and after him, they have changed a lot of the verdicts, but they kept the methodology. And why? Because they had other debates, other discussion, other exposure to other hadith and so on. And we will talk about that later on. So with this kind of setting, Abu Hanifa was very keen on having like democracy of the knowledgeable people. And he created also the system of tafarrug, which means full-time scholarship. So you won't be worried about your business, making living and so on. And from his own money, and we have mentioned that he makes hundreds of thousands of dollars every year, he would spend, he lives on minimum wage, or he lives on the poverty line level, 4,000 dirham a year for him and his family. And the rest of his money, he gives it to his students. And this is what we should do here with our zakah money and sadaqah money, to invest it in the students who are poor and needy. Of course, they are eligible to zakah, but not to disperse it all over the world, because that will give support to learning establishment for Darul Ulum and Darul Nur and so on. But this is an opinion. I might be wrong. And he was very keen on asking.